to join in prayer. No, I guess it depends on your own biography as to how you feel about this incredible place that we're in tonight. It is quite marvellous, and on an event of art, science and the truth, we're overlooked by the Lady of Truth herself with her extremely blonde hair, almost bare breasts, and a very beautiful blue dress. So it's quite lots of symbolism going on here, and that's a lot of the point, actually. So, hello and welcome. I'm Laura Sillis, the Artistic Director at Site Gallery. Tonight is a really special event for us. It's the first of our site sessions, which are part of a hugely ambitious project called City of Ideas. And this is one of the things that we're doing at Site Gallery while we're closed. And it has brought together incredible partners from the Sheffield area to think about how we might look at a city. How does a city work? Who runs a city? Where do artists sit within that? Where does creativity sit within that? Can we do things differently? Can we think about space differently? Can we think about power differently? Can we think about people differently? And tonight is our first event. And I hope you'll have a fantastic time and get to know some of our speakers intimately through the process. Over to you, Vega.
Thank you.
After each of their short talks, in short, maybe 10 to 15 minutes, you guys are going to throw any questions at them about what they've just said. So it's not kind of a panel yet, but it's anything that you've just thought of while you're talking or something to clarify. So there'll be an opportunity to talk to them straight away. And then after the three talks, we're going to have a break and we're going to go to the bar, which is follow the corridor and try and remember where you went, because it's quite labyrinthine and difficult. This is the wooden door. Remember what it looks like from both sides. We've all got lost tonight trying to get back into this room. It's quite like, yeah, something from C.S. Lewis. So do remember where you went. Find the bar. It's just at the end of the corridor. And then come back. But that'll probably be about an hour or so's time. And then when we come back from the break, you'll all have had a chance to think about what you've heard and what you want to discuss and what the themes are and what your own interests are on the subject. So you can start really involving yourselves with the panel and have a big panel discussion. So, as well afterwards, just to say, if anyone wants to go to the pub after, we'll probably be done by about 9:30, 10:30. There's two pubs right opposite. One is called Brown and Bear, which is a Sam Smith, so it's quite cheap. It's quite local, if you know what I mean, I think. But it's cheap, so you know. Whereas next door to there, there's the Head of Steam, which is the one I'm going to go to, because that's my job. Tonight I am the Head of Steam. So there's the Head of Steam is a kind of very good choice. So I dare say you didn't know where to go. These are our speakers for tonight. They're actually in the wrong order, but that's fine. Katharine Vega is an artist I've got a line about. She's an artist and educator, often working with science and technology and the body. And so she's going to be talking about perception of the body in her work and having a little demo, I think, as well. That'd be great. Dr. Sean Powell is a philosopher who's come all the way from Dublin today, and he works at the University College. Trinity, and he's very interested in time and has worked with lots of artists and scientists too. And Simon Lewis is the culture editor at New Scientist magazine, which I'm sure you're familiar with. He's also a writer, author, he writes science fiction, and most recently has written a book called Stalin and Scientists, which is non-fiction. And he's going to talk a little bit about some of the things he's sort of been thinking about as a result of that. So truth is a big subject, we realised as we started to plan this event after deciding we were going to do it anyway. We'll only scratch the surface tonight, so we kind of have to make peace with that, I think. The arts have an interesting relationship to truth. They are artifice, of course, by definition, but at their best, they are a light that shines on truth, and the feelings and ideas they deal in are very much of the real world. An artwork or an art form can express something true with astonishing accuracy. A truthful performance from an actor, a truthful dance, but this truth has nothing to do with something looking like what it's supposed to. It's the truth embedded in the ideals and structures, the truths hidden in effective fairy tales. But wherever there's a story, there's also a sort of lie. Picasso said, art is the lie which makes us see the truth. So my own question as someone interested in interdisciplinary collaboration is, how might the sciences, if they reject untruth, work fruitfully with this liar? We live in an age not just of fake news, but of fake news. Digital facilitates the blurring of the real and the imaginary, and often prioritises the unreal in this grand battle for our attention. Our attention is the premium of our times. In many ways, it is the force that bends the truth. Where is the truth? If the instruments and amplifiers of our attention are no longer trustworthy, the speakers tonight each come at the question from different angles, as we'll discuss shortly. But my own interest as an artist, and I suppose in life generally, is in finding the most honest expression of an idea. I have a foot in the digital world, and I see more storytelling in digital culture than in any other world I've inhabited. It's a new place, digital, with wizards and gurus and trolls, of course, and intrepid heroes and all the problems that come with overexcitement and fantasy. When this hastily imposed culture is stripped away, what's left of digital? What is a technology of truth? And this isn't specifically something we're going to talk about tonight, though we could if you wanted to, but it's something that interests me, and that's kind of where I come from. What would a technology of truth look like? Last year, I was the first digital artist in residence at Lombard, which is the UK's leading dance company. And I began to explore what felt to me like an aesthetics of truth. This was inspired by an aesthetics of truth that I felt contemporary dance was doing so well itself. Stories are left behind as the body, the personality, and the present moment are found to be extraordinary enough in their honesty. These are the third images I took of the dancers while they were warming up. They're all from Edinburgh when they were on tour on stage. So I want to start this event series with these themes: science and truth, and how they relate to art. It feels very timely. Wherever there is science or digital, questions of reality, belief, and truth always follow. Just this week, we had a TED talk from the Pope. Anyway, let's get on with the presentations. I've asked each of the speakers to present about 10 to 15 minutes on their take on the subjects before we sit down to chat in more detail and have a break, like just explained beforehand. And then we'll take some questions after each talk too. So let's start with Dr. Sean Power, all the way from Trinity. Got that right this time.
Offer his philosophical take on truth and belief. And we just need to get his slides up.
Let's
move over there.
Hi.
So thanks very much for that. That's fantastic. Thank you for
you're welcome.
Inviting me over. I think it's my first time doing something like this in the UK. I've done a lot of this stuff. I've done a lot of things like this in Ireland. Or a little, not things like exactly like this on a panel or so on, but I've done a mixture of technology or art and science and philosophy and talks, but at least small ones, and so it's really great to do it over here. I have a talk about 10 or 11 slides, for example, which is a little 10-minute talk I planned for today. But when I came in, you also asked them, I might talk about what I've actually already done in relation to art and science and so on. Because I'm a philosopher, not an artist, and I'm not a